Hi, I'm Jean Riddell, and I decided to make this short presentation because many of my students seem to be having a lot of trouble understanding what Lewis phenotype a person will have based on their genotype. Please watch the other video on the Lewis blood group system first, or make sure you have at least read about the blood group before listening to this video. So I've titled this Lewis Genes and Antigens Simplified. The Lewis antigens and their genes. The genes that affect the Lewis blood group are capital LE, lowercase LE, capital SE, lowercase SE, and the antigens are Lewis A and Lewis B. The genes that affect the Lewis antigen expression are the Lewis and secretor genes. The Lewis A and Lewis B are not alleles of this blood group. There are not Lewis A and Lewis B genes. If you start here, you can create a flowchart that will help you determine the Lewis phenotype from the genes inherited. The first question you want to ask is, does the person have the capital LE gene? People who are homozygous for lowercase LE will answer no. These people are always Lewis A negative, B negative. People who are homozygous for capital LE or heterozygous for capital LE and lowercase LE will be yes. If the answer is yes, the next question you ask is, do they have the secretor gene? Please continue to the next slide. The next question to ask is, does the person carry the capital SE gene? If yes, they are homozygous or heterozygous for the capital SE gene, and they are Lewis A negative, B positive. If they are homozygous for the lowercase SE gene, then they are Lewis A positive, B negative. The chart shows you the genes with the phenotypes that they create. If you have a capital LE and a SE, then you are Lewis A negative, B positive. If you have the capital LE gene but are homozygous for the lowercase SE gene, then you are Lewis A positive, B negative. If you are homozygous for lowercase LE, it does not matter what your secretor gene status is, you are Lewis A negative, B negative. Now this last line we haven't talked about, and it isn't included in the flowchart. This would be important to include in the Asian population, as this can be 10 to 40% of the population. The secretor gene in this case is weak, which leads to both antigens being detected on the red blood cells. When you see the capital SE and capital LE genes, you should select the Lewis A negative, B positive as the phenotype on an exam unless they tell you the person is Asian and carries a weak capital SE gene. This is rare in white and black populations, but 10 to 40% is in the Asian population. Things to remember about the Lewis blood group system. Lewis A and Lewis B are not alleles. Lewis antibodies are usually IgM. Lewis antibodies do not cause hemolytic disease of the fetus and newborn. Lewis antibodies are made by Lewis A negative, B negative people. All fetuses and newborns are Lewis A negative, B negative. Lewis antigens are absorbed onto red blood cells. Things to remember continued. If Lewis antibodies react at 37, give cross-match compatible units. Pregnant women become Lewis A negative, B negative temporarily. Here are some questions that you can use to help you study. You can pause the video if you want to answer yourself before I give the answer. Question 1. If a patient has the following genes, what is their Lewis phenotype? The genes are AO, capital H, lowercase h, capital LE, lowercase LE, capital SE, capital SE. The choices are A, Lewis A positive, B negative, B, Lewis A negative, B positive, C, Lewis A negative, B negative, D, Lewis A positive, B positive. The answer is B, Lewis A negative, B positive. Notice there are some extra genes listed that do not affect the Lewis type. First ask, does the person have the capital LE gene? Yes, they do. Then ask, do they have the capital SE gene? And they do. Therefore, the type is Lewis A negative, B positive. Question 2. If the patient has the following genes, what is their Lewis phenotype? A, B, lowercase h, lowercase h, capital LE, lowercase LE, lowercase SE, lowercase SE. The choices are A, Lewis A positive, B negative, B, Lewis A negative, B positive, C, Lewis A negative, B negative, D, Lewis A positive, B positive. The answer is A, Lewis A positive, B negative. Notice that the person does have the capital LE gene, but does not have the capital SE gene. Question 3. If a patient has the following genes, what is their Lewis phenotype? AO, D, capital C, lowercase e, capital H, lowercase h, lowercase LE, lowercase LE, capital SE, capital SE. The answer is C, Lewis A negative, B negative. The person does not have the capital LE gene, and it does not matter if they have the capital SE gene. If a person is homozygous lowercase LE, the answer is always Lewis A negative, B negative. Do not look at the secretor gene at all. Question 4. If a patient has the following genes, what is their Lewis phenotype? OO, lowercase D, C, E, capital H, lowercase H, capital LE, lowercase LE, capital SE, lowercase SE. The choices are Lewis A positive, B negative, Lewis A positive, A negative, sorry, B, Lewis A negative, B positive, C, Lewis A negative, B negative, D, Lewis A positive, B positive. The answer to question 4 is Lewis A negative, B positive. The person has the capital LE and the capital SE gene, which makes them Lewis B, the Lewis B antigen. Question 5. If a patient tests positive for Lewis A and Lewis B antigens, the answers are A, they are black, have capital LE, lowercase LE, capital SE, lowercase SE, B, they are white, lowercase LE, lowercase LE, lowercase SE, lowercase SE, C, they are Asian, lowercase LE, lowercase LE, capital SE, W, lowercase SE, D, Asian, capital LE, lowercase LE, capital SE, W, lowercase SE. It is highly unusual for a person to test positive for both Lewis A and Lewis B. This type is rare among both white and black individuals. This is more common among Asian populations. So we notice that the person in C does not have the capital LE gene and is Lewis A negative, B negative. The person described in D is Asian and has a weak secretor gene, would be the most likely to be Lewis A positive, B positive. Question 6. If a patient tests positive for Lewis A and negative for Lewis B, are they a secretor of ABH substances? The answers are A, yes, B, no, C, unable to determine. The answer is B, no, this person is not a secretor of ABH substances. Question 7. If a patient tests negative for Lewis A and negative for Lewis B, are they a secretor of ABH substances? The answers are A, yes, B, no, C, unable to determine. The answer to question 7 is C, we are unable to determine the secretor status of a Lewis A negative, B negative individual without further testing. Question 8. If a patient tests negative for Lewis A and positive for Lewis B, are they a secretor of ABH substances? The answers are A, yes, B, no, C, unable to determine. The answer is yes. A person who is Lewis B positive is always a secretor of ABH substances. If a patient tests positive for Lewis A and positive for Lewis B, are they a secretor of ABH substances? The answers are A, yes, B, no, C, unable to determine. The answer is yes, because they have the Lewis B, they must be a secretor. Remember, if you have a Lewis gene and no secretor gene, you are only Lewis A positive. But if you have Lewis B, you must be a secretor. A Lewis A negative, B negative individual can be a secretor or a non-secretor, but further testing would be required to determine if the person is a secretor. Thank you for listening. I hope this helps you understand the Lewis blood group phenotypes.